Markets ended a volatile week on a mixed note. Chinese shares outperformed on more promises of stimulus from the government to boost consumer spending and local liquidity. China's central bank also telling real estate developers they would be allowed to sell bonds to raise funds. Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of Japan's SoftBank gained after reporting a 2.1% increase in first quarter profit. Toyota shares also rose, picking up 1.15% as it announced plans to mass produce robo-taxis in China with its Chinese partner Pony AI. Here at home, Philippine shares slumped even after data showed inflation slowed for a sixth straight month in July. The main index fell back to the 6,400 level to post a weekly loss of 2.6%.
Largely, we are still within that trading range. That trading range is between 6,300 to 6,700. And I think what we're seeing really is that there's short-term trading positions wherein we come in, wherein some investors come in at 6,300 and then they take, you know, what spread they can, particularly because the market hasn't really been exciting. In terms of going beyond the range. A lot of times in the market, we're driven by sentiment, we're driven by growth forecasts. Mm-hmm. But today, I think investors are more wary considering all of the risks involved globally.
Here are some local corporate headlines. The Philippine Tax Bureau ordered to refund or issue a 122 million peso tax credit to San Miguel Brewery. The Court of Tax Appeals ruled SMB was erroneously and illegally taxed on the removal of beer products from six plants. SMB has yet to issue a statement on the matter. Shares of San Miguel Food and Beverage gained nearly 1% in Friday trade. Meanwhile, Jollibee partners with Titan Dining subsidiary FCPL to bring two Singapore brands to Manila, Chong Bahru Bakery and Common Man Coffee Roasters. Jollibee and FCPL agreed to a 60-40 ownership scheme and committed to invest up to 250 million pesos. The fast food giant shares rose a tenth of a percent. Integrated Microelectronics sells its 80% stake in STI Enterprises to London-based investment firm R Capital. The sale is valued at around 7.5 million pounds. IMI says the move is part of its strategy to sharpen its portfolio and focus on profitability and growth. The company shares rose over 2%. And finally, Universal Robina posts a 19% rise in its second quarter profit. This brings its first half earnings to 7 billion pesos. The company says its growth signals resilient consumer demand. URC shares surrendered to the market downturn, dropping over 3%.
Philippine inflation nearing the top end of government's 2-4% target as it eased for a sixth straight month in July. But economists warn the prices of commodities may remain high due to volatile weather disturbances. Lady Vicencio has the details.
Philippine headline inflation continued its downward trend as it eased further to 4.7% in July from 5.4% in June. July's inflation rate is the lowest in 16 months. The Philippine Statistics Authority attributed the slowdown to the softening of housing and electricity prices. Prices of select food and non-alcoholic drinks, while transport commodities registered negative inflation. Core inflation also eased to 6.7% in July. Economic managers now more confident inflation will hit government's 2-4% target range by the end of the fourth quarter of this year. However, PSA is monitoring the impact of recent typhoons to commodity prices in the coming months. Vegetable prices have gone up in the past month to 21.8% from 12.7% in June, while rice prices have been slightly rising for the past 6 months.
Normally naman, mayroon tayong impact kaagad doon sa vegetables, for example. Ano? So nakita natin naman na may pagtaas na yung ating vegetables. So normally, yun ang unang tumataas. But we will see, kasi you will notice medyo dynamic yung ating ng movement ng 13 commodity groups.
Meanwhile, cooling inflation have yet to be felt by consumers, especially the bottom 30% income households.
It's not really a price decrease, you know, it's just that prices have been rising slower than the past power of the consumers were still not really feeling it. I mean, personally, ako din hindi ko ma-feel yung groceries and stuff. They're still a little bit elevated. The prices we are paying is still high compared to last year.
The National Economic and Development Authority said the Philippines needs to be vigilant to potential risks such as volatile weather disturbances, oil price hikes, and food trade restrictions. Meanwhile, the Department of Finance remains confident that inflation could settle between the target range of 2-4% before the end of the year. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.